In this episode, we head to northern Hants County here in Nova Scotia. The mission is to visit a variety of smaller abandoned mine opening sites, some of which we know are here and some are just suspected prospects. Either way, we're going to take you along for the ride. Each of these is small enough that I don't think they would have warranted their own individual episode, so what we're going to do is mash them here all together into one sort of mine day extravaganza, and we're going to take you along for the ride. So let's go! Stop on the journey today is the WALTON BARITE MINE area. The first thing you see when you get back into the old mining area, this reclaimed mine site, the quarry is of course the first thing you see. It's unmistakable and unmissable. So the quarry as you see it right now, having water virtually to the top in relation to its depth, it's still far down from the surface here. But if you could imagine several hundred feet below the water, how it goes straight down the walls. If you go to the edge of the water, as you can see in some of these shots, the shoreline, if you want to call it that, only goes into the water a few feet and then it just drops straight off into the abyss. The little offshoot over to the side that you see in the distance is actually the up ramp, so to speak, to get up and out of the quarry. Of course, now it just looks like a long arm of water. But that is the slope that goes down into the quarry where they brought the ore out. Now, of course, in a moment here, we're going to throw up some historical photos. Not very high resolution, but about the best we can get on the internet these days of what the old mine looked like when it was in operation. This quarry was started back in the 1940s. Now, this site, of course, doesn't finish with the quarry at all. In 1955, a company named Dresser Industries purchased the quarry, and not only did they continue with the quarry, but they went down into the grounds here to go not only below the quarry, but far out from the quarry in all of these fields that you see around. But starting in 1955, they began to sink a shaft here, and that's of course what we're going to try and find next. The old number 2 main shaft from Dresser Industries started in 1955. It went all the way to 1968 where they hit a depth of 1700 feet. This shaft goes straight down. It does go to multiple levels. Now we'll pull out some old historical maps here that we did find and put them up on the screen. Of course today the shaft as we found it is concrete capped and labeled. Just in the field here in some bushes off to the side of the quarry. What ended up happening with Dresser Industries is they ended up hitting terrible flooding down in the mine. By 1971, they had to give up on everything below the 850-foot level and just let it go. The mine did close in 1978, 7 years after that, and that's kind of you know when it all ended for this area as far as high production. Up until that time, this mine was produced 90% of the barite in all of Canada, coast to coast. This was the biggest barite production area in the country for decades. All right, the march continues. And now we're going to continue on to hunt down this adit that we believe is here. There should be a little adit here, not too far from the quarry, and we're going to hunt through the woods here and actually try to find it. We're here! Okay, we've bushwhacked through quite a bit of wet greenery, and just through here, we can, whoops! Just through here, we can confirm that we have located this very, very well buried adit. We have confirmed a mouth. Oh, there we go. There it is. Amazing. Very well hidden in the forest near the big flooded quarry.
I see your helmet.
The rest of the team's coming. It's like the rainforest in here. But man, this is well tucked away, this one. All right, we're heading in. My goodness. This is like a... It's like one of those Vietnamese tunnels that the Viet Cong dug. Very narrow and totally round arch. All right. We're going up to the end. As we know, these are very small candidates. That's why we're stopping at a bunch of these on this little Hants County tour. But yeah, this just slopes up to a an end right there. Oh yeah, we are not going any further than this. This is entirely animal feces. So here's looking back to the outdoors. I'd say this one, I don't know, maybe 80 feet long. We're waiting for our last soldier. Are you coming? Photos must be taken, as you will see featured on our Facebook page from our friendly open exposure mine photographer. And we're done. On to the next one, folks. Okay, we're out of the truck and heading to our first point. We think it's down in here. Supposedly an incline shaft at a 45 degree angle that is backfilled to some degree, but does have some length to it. Looks like it's all been backfilled by garbage by the look of things. If there is an opening here, it might be under this. You think you see something? Okay, they say they found something up here. We're coming along a ridge here that drops in the forest floor. So it's kind of like a brook bed, kind of. No, actually it's not, because it ends right there. Oh, they found something. Look at this. Is it an inclined shaft?
It is, yeah.
Well. Okay, I stepped up on the ridge at the other side here, just so we can get a point of view from up high. This is what we found. And it does go down. There's some wood cribbing down into it there. We don't know if that's a plug that's broken through or just timbers that fell down in it, but we're gonna go investigate. Okay, opening up the iris, here's what it looks like down in there. There's allegedly a drift off to the left there. How far does that go? Can you see or tell? And looking down through the timbers there, what's down there?
It looks like it goes down and stops.
Okay, so it may be a dead ender. Again, these are fairly small finds, folks, but we don't know till we explore them. Let's go down. Okay, there's that tunnel to the left. We'll just take a little peek-see in there. All right, here's inside. Goes up to a little crawl there, like you said. Yeah, it's all animal shit up in there. There's some strange fungus growing out of it. That white stuff up there that looks like white grass. And down here, there's a little stope they took out in there. It's hard to light it because it's very narrow getting in there. Lots of shit in that white fungus in there too. So looking back out to the slope. Okay, he's heading down the 45 degree.
There's ice down there.
Ice? Interesting, we're gonna have a look at that. He's heading down the 45 degree incline shaft here. Here's looking back up to the forest. Like I say, there's all the stuff that looked like an attempt at plugging this, all thrown down. Are you reporting officially a dead end, or are you...
Yeah, it's officially a dead end.
No, it is. It just goes down to there. Now, does it look plugged, or do they just ended?
They just ended it. There's no plug.
Okay. Here's through the logs. And that is the bottom, right?
That is the bottom.
Okay. And I just want to point out over here, this ice. That is ice, folks. And it is early July. And there's still ice in these. So somehow, even though it doesn't feel it, this keeps that below zero for frozen. Doesn't feel like it's below zero in here. So you'd think there'd be some melt to it, but it's lasted long. Okay, we're going to pull back out. Go on to the next one. So there's the hole down there in the distance on the way out of the trench that it's down in. We notice as we come up here, of course, lots of DNR signs. There's one over there in the distance. One over there. They're everywhere! The hunt continues, folks. Just so you get a feel of what it looks like. You just kind of... You bushwhack, oh, we have a find. See, you come across all these orange signs just like this. And it's just sign, sign, sign everywhere. Okay. This is the shaft. So we've got a big sinkhole. You know, normally these don't interest us too much, but when they're significant and big, does it have any hint of an opening, or is it just fully plugged?
It's opening. There's a, I don't know, 3-4 feet.
There's a 3 or 4 foot opening? I'm gonna have to come around to that side. He's down there taking a little looky-loo. This is what's at the bottom of this sinkhole. What do you think?
No.
Nothing. Might have been something, but it's nothing.
I really didn't guess that's not.
All right, we'll move on to the next one. We got our hopes up there. Okay, we're coming up on what he says appears to be a foreshore hole. There's a huge garbage dump in the background there. People must love these trenches to throw their crap into. But it's looking very familiar, like the last one where there's a big cavern going down here to the left. Except this one seems to have some pluggage. Yeah, it's like they've filled it full of garbage, but I do see a...
That might be your other shaft in there, too. Right
there. Yeah. There's an opening there to the right. Yeah, there's probably a good 50-foot rise there up to the forest floor, and we're down in this trenchy thing full of garbage, and this garbage-filled incline shaft, which looks similar to the last one, how it was cut, but of course there's friggin' car hoods and garbage and stereos and cabinetry thrown in it, plus all this crap over here. Okay, so we're gonna go down close for you guys and have a look in this opening that's to the right of this giant car hood that's plugging everything. If I don't kill myself slipping down the mud here. Let's go. Yeah, it looks like a lid of something, or goodness great, I don't know. Anyway, that's where it ends, folks, so it just looks kind of like a bear cave. It looks like it's been all backfilled with crap and everything thrown down in there. All right, so we'll head on to the next one. Okay, we followed the old mine road a little further. Another GPS point here just in the trees, and the signage is up. And the boys say there's a collapse shaft in here, which is what the GPS points were indicating. So let's have a look at it. Yeah, sort of an indentation in the ground and a bunch of crap thrown in it. There is a little black opening there on the back wall. Did you guys look at that?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, everything here is a no-go. So we're going to move on to our next point and the last point for this area, and it's supposed to be another incline shaft. So let's go have a look. We have a salamander that almost got stepped on. Oh, I see an orange sign in the distance. A couple of them, actually.
Found it.
We hear a shout of found it. Let's go. Okay, here we are. And there's some orange tape over here. They just told me it was plugged. So it's more of just a big dangerous sinkhole in the middle of the forest that you could fall down into, and yep, there it is. That's all she wrote for that one. Nice little tree growing in the bottom. They found something else here behind me, so... Okay, there they go. They continue to follow the orange signs. And, another big chasm down into the forest floor here. This one much deeper, maybe 20-25 feet. We're still heading to that other incline shaft. The GPS point still remains in the distance, but we find this stuff on the way, so... Let's keep going. So I must correct myself. We are over here on the other side and have gone to the final point and discovered it was this, just the trees screw with the GPS. And we went right past this and the flag ended up behind us on our GPS. So this was the last alleged incline shaft and it looks like it's collapsed down there with a bunch of logs and trees. Unfortunately, nothing. So we're heading on to the next site. Getting back in the vehicles and heading out. Bye-bye.